The Garmin G1000 is extremely capable. It will display and follow vertical navigation guidance in addition to lateral guidance. This feature is called VNAV, and in this video, we'll show you how VNAV can help you plan descents, and we'll look at some common VNAV traps. VNAV is a very complex feature found in the G1000 in the airline world. We use VNAV on almost every flight. Because the simulator at SimTech Aviation has the GFC-700 autopilot and all of the features of the G1000, we're going to show you how to use VNAV to comply with a crossing restriction. Here we are for the demonstration of the VNAV function, and we are at cruise at 11,000 feet, and we just got a crossing restriction to cross Minock at 4,000 feet. So the first thing I'm gonna do is on my altitude alerter, I'm gonna set the new altitude clearance of 4,000. And then on the MFD flight plan, I'll bring up the flight plan, click the FMS knob to bring the cursor up and scroll to my intersection Minock, and ATC cross says cross Minock at 4,000. So I'll set that new restriction in and push enter to confirm that. And the VNAV profile is telling us our target vertical speed is going to be just about 500 feet a minute and a 1.5 degree flight path angle. And that gives us a 500 foot per minute descent. That'll be nice and comfortable. I'll take that. When you move into pressurized airplanes, it becomes a 3 degree glide slope is standard, and click the FMS knob to clear that. That said, it's giving us a top of descent in 4.5 minutes roughly. We're looking for the vertical deviation indicator to come up before we do anything else. We don't want to start down yet, because it's more efficient to fly at higher altitudes. All right, so now that vertical deviation indicator just popped up here. When that pops up, that's our cue to push the VNAV button, and it's armed with that VPath in white there. You can see on the vertical speed, we have target vertical speed is dropping down towards 500 feet a minute. We're correcting on the course here. We sped up the sim and got just slightly off course. And you can see VPath has become active there on the AFCS mode annunciator. And reducing power slightly as we start the descent so we don't overspeed. Or let the speed pick up a little bit in the descent if you want. You can see our vertical speed settling in there at about what was predicted, 450, 500 feet a minute. And a little bit of turn anticipation for our course change on the airway over Pontiac. You can see on the MFD predicted altitudes at those waypoints, Pontiac was 10,700 is what it was predicting. So we hit that basically right on. Motif 65 and then for it, which is our restriction. Now watch this quick time lapse of the descent so you can see how the VNAV function works on a long descent like this. Now, as we're getting closer to the bottom of this descent and it was predicting Motif at 6,500, I'm checking the math on this. But helping me on that is I've got this little blue arc where it's predicting we're gonna level off. And that is just beyond Minock there, but on our side of Minock now. So I'm watching that, but it looks like we're gonna hit our restriction. We'll pay closer attention as we get a little bit closer, but we've got just over 6 miles to lose 1,000 feet to cross Motif at the predicted 65, which seems on track, and the math adds up to then hit Minock at 4. All right, coming up on the last 1,000 feet here, we've still got 8 miles, so I'm confident that we're gonna make this restriction. Now, as we were talking about before with checking the altitudes, that the VNAV populates automatically and just doing some mental math to back up the VNAV system, we don't wanna just blindly rely on the automated systems of the airplane. All right, and there we're capturing just at Minock. Add a little power as we level off, and there's your VNAV. There's an example of how VNAV could be used on an en route descent. Now, for this example, we plugged in Joliet Airport as our destination. If that was our destination, either en route or at the top of that descent, we would have been getting weather and setting up for the approach. And a whole host of other things, running checklists. But for the purposes of this video, we wanted to just highlight the VNAV function. That's one of the beauties of the sim. We can just focus on one thing and we don't have to deal with multiple other distractions that you have to deal with in the real world, because it's the real world. If you have questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them in the comments below.